Sri Lankan shares closed lower today after news that despite widespread protests, the president of the debt-heavy island nation currently facing an economic crisis would not resign. At the close of trade, the CSE All Share Index settled 1.8% lower at 8,580.93 points. Sri Lanka sovereign dollar bonds dropped more than 3 cents against the dollar today. Meanwhile, Sri Lankan doctors joined protests in the commercial capital Colombo as hospitals run out of essential drugs because of the country's worst economic crisis in decades. Even as the government appealed for calm, people have been suffering from shortages of fuel, power, food and other items for weeks, and doctors say the entire health system could now collapse. Today, the BMC has said in a media release that India's first case of coronavirus variant XE was reported in Mumbai. One case of the Kappa variant has also been detected. The patients with the new variants of the virus don't have any severe symptoms so far. World Health Organization has said last week that the new mutant may be more transmissible than any strain of COVID-19. In a meeting with Prime Minister Narendra Modi, Nationalist Congress Party leader Sharad Pawar raised the Central Probe Agency's actions against leaders of Maharashtra's ruling coalition and other politicians bitterly opposed to the BJP. The two spoke for about 20 minutes at PM Modi's office in the parliament, hours after the Enforcement Directorate seized the properties of Shiv Sena leader Sanjay Raut's wife Varsha Raut and a relative of Aam Aadmi Party leader and Delhi Minister Satyendra Jain in an alleged money laundering case. Today, Tamil Nadu Chief Minister M.K. Stalin said his DMK government was constrained to revise the property tax to ensure funds flow to the newly elected civic bodies so as to facilitate developmental activities, and appealed to the political parties to not politicize the issue. Turning down a plea by various political parties, including his allies in the assembly, to either roll back the recently announced revision or announce a cut, the Chief Minister said that the property tax revision was not deliberate but had to be done to financially empower the civic bodies.